G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. Today I'm going to do a helicopter battle scene using this city as my backdrop here. So as usual, let's get started. So you can see this is the photo that I'm going to use. So the first thing I did using my selection brush tool was just made a selection of the city, and then I just made a new layer just with this city on it here without the sky. But we're going to keep this turned on because we're still going to use all of this picture. So the next thing I'm going to do is bring over my new sky, which is going to be this sort of sunset and clouds. We're going to copy that over with a Command C. Come over to this picture and I'm going to put it in between both of these layers. So Command V. Grab my Move tool and then just move this up. So I've got that picture of the sun and the clouds in there, right up to about there. And I'm going to change the blend mode to that to lighten. Let's have a look to lighten just here, just so I've got the clouds and that sun in there. I'm going to add another layer on top of the sun here. This is just going to be a new pixel layer. And come up here to my brushes. Now you can use a basic soft brush for this. I've got these brushes that I'm going to use, which are these smoke brushes here. And I'm going to use this one down here. Make sure my color, I'm going to pick this gray color of the smoke and activate it. And then on this layer with my brush, make that a bit smaller, my brush. Make sure that color is activated. And I'm just going to enhance the smoke that's already here a little bit behind here and add a little bit more smoke in. And that looks pretty good. So I've got my smoke in place now. Next thing I'm going to add into this picture is the picture of the fire. So I'm just going to copy that with a Command C. Come over here to the picture here, and right on top here, Command V, changing the blend mode to that to screen. And make my picture a little bit smaller now using my Command minus. Click on our Move tool as well. And a little bit smaller, and just going to stretch this fire out and make it a little bit bigger. And then I'm going to go arrange and flip horizontal and then bring it sort of about there. Looks pretty good. Command zero to get back to our normal size. And you can see that I've got this line here. So let's just fix that up. So we want to just drag that out down. So we don't want to see that line. Okay, that looks a bit better. So Command zero, we've got no line. We've got our smoke in place. Okay, the next thing I'm going to bring over is my helicopter. Now I've already cut this helicopter out as well, and I've added some bullet holes and just some glass shattered here. So the bullet holes were added and the glass was added just using the blend modes of lighten and overlay. And if anyone's really interested in how I did that, leave me a comment below and we can do a video of how I created that. But I will make this helicopter available for you on the Buy Me a Coffee site. So let's just copy that over, Command C. Back over here again to our picture, right on top, Command V. So we've got our helicopter here. I'm going to make two more copies, Command J, Command J. So I've got three copies of this helicopter. On the first one here, let's make our picture a little bit smaller again so we can bring this one into place. This one's going to be really big right in the corner here. This is going to be our focus, our first helicopter, right in the corner and quite big. And he's sort of looking down at those flames. The next helicopter we'll make a little bit bigger and he's going to be a bit straighter. So sort of in the middle here. We can have a play with these sizes a little bit later, and then the last helicopter is going to be right in the corner, right at the back here. He's already banking away from those flames, so let's make that a bit bigger. That and that's not looking too bad at the moment. So my next picture is another helicopter picture, and I've just made it look like it's exploding. And if anybody wants to know how I've done that, I'll just quickly show you just with this helicopter here. All I've done is taken my pen tool and then just sort of made a rough selection around the helicopter and then over to selection. And then with your command X to cut and command V to copy, take away the marching ants. And if you come back to your move tool, then you can start moving bits of the helicopter around. And I've just cut certain bits of this helicopter out, added some flames behind, and that's a firework, a sparkler firework. And this picture at the back here, this sort of zoomy picture, was just used some fire and the filter, which was blur and zoom blur, so just to make that effect there. So again, if you want more in depth of how I created this helicopter and explosion, just again let me know in the comments below. So command C, we're going to copy this over, come over to our picture, and again just right underneath all of these helicopters above the flames, we'll go command V, bring that one down, make it a bit bigger, turn it a little bit and put it right down in the corner here where it's just been hit. About there, looks pretty good. Okay, command zero. So we've got all our helicopters in place and we've got our explosion in place here. So the next thing I'm going to do is add some highlights to the helicopters. So the first one here, going to come down here to adjustments and recolor. So I'm going to clip that recolor to the first helicopter, and then I'm just going to use my hue slider here just to bring that up into the sort of flamey orange color. And then I'm going to hit command I to invert it. Back on my brush tool, going to make sure this time I've got a nice soft basic brush. Sort of in this range here. The color we're going to be painting is white, so let's hit D on our keyboards to get the colors back to default and X to get the colors onto white. My flow is going to be 60%. My opacity I'm going to drop to 50. And the hardness is 0. And I'm just going to make my brush a little bit bigger. And I'm going to start going around putting some highlights from the sort of flames onto the helicopter here. And some on the blade. Make my brush a little bit bigger. I'll do these areas down here and some just across here. I'm also going to add another adjustment now, which is going to be an exposure. Going to clip that to the helicopter and make that a lot brighter. And again, I'm going to invert that with a command I. I'm still using the same brush, the same flow. I'm just going to put some highlights on this side and a little bit underneath there. Okay, I'm going to do the same to both of these helicopters here. So what I'm going to do is just copy these two, exposure and recolor, and go command J. And then I'm going to clip them to the second helicopter. Clicking on the recolor, I'm going to do the same again. Put some recolor underneath. Again, I'm doing this fairly quickly, guys, so you can take a lot more time when you do it for yourself. Okay, sort of happy with that. Like I said, I've done it fairly quickly. I'd usually take a lot more time. Now, as we can see, our sort of red background, our red sky doesn't quite match our picture. So I'm going to come down here to our red background, our red sky with the clouds, and add a recolor onto that as well. Clip it. And just bring that up a little bit till I just get that orangey color. I think about there is pretty good. So we're looking pretty good. So what I'm going to do now is right on top here on my live filters, I'm going to add a depth of blur. And I want this one just to be standalone. So I'm going to drag it out and drag it up to the top. I'm going to place it just on this helicopter here. And I'm going to bring that radius up to 4. Just blurs out these helicopters a little bit and keeps our focus right on this one here. So I'm pretty happy with that. Going to add another adjustment now right on top, down to adjustments, and this one's going to be selective color here. Right on top here, going to make sure this little drop down box says neutrals, and in the cyan, I'm going to make that 35, hit enter. Yellow, I'm going to make that minus 15 and hit enter. Get that little bit of color into our picture. And I might just play with these flames a little bit, and I'm going to bring them up in front of our helicopters, I think, just to put that flame sort of dancing up into our helicopter there. That looks a little bit better. And then right on top, let's just now merge all this together, which we can come up here to layer and merge visible. Here you can use your develop persona if you want to, but I'm going to use my tone mapping as I usually do, just to get some more of that detail into my picture here, and bring my tone compression down to 20. And I'm going to bring my exposure down, and I'm going to bring the saturation down a little bit as well, and the vibrance up. So I'm pretty happy with that. So I'm going to hit apply. So there we go. That's my picture of the helicopter battle. But I'm going to do one more little thing just to make it look a little bit more arty. And this is purely optional. But I just really love this filter down here on the live filters, all the way down the bottom, this procedural texture here. I'm going to click on that. And the preset I'm going to use is metallic. And I'm just going to bring this slider pretty much all the way down, maybe about there. You can play with this and see what you like. But I'm also on that procedural text going to bring that down to about 45%. And there we go, everybody. Like I said, that is purely optional. You can take it or leave it. I sort of like the way it looks. But there you go, everybody. That is my tutorial this week on creating that helicopter battle over that city. If you have enjoyed the tutorial, please give it a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. I will have the helicopter with the bullet holes and the glass and the helicopter exploding on the Buy Me a Coffee site. So if you'd like to support my channel, head over there. They'll be absolutely free for you to grab and use in your own pictures. But until next time, I'm going to say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.